So, this is my Daytona 500 wrap-up. I know it's about 5 days late. It's almost time for the next race, but I wanted to record my thoughts about the race. I told myself I would try to record some thoughts after each race this year. Not sure why, but thought it might be fun. So, of course, you all know I'm a big Tony Stewart fan. Number 14, yay, Office Max. Office Depot, sorry. Oops. Wow. Office Depot. So Tony wins the race on Saturday, the nationwide race, which I thought should be a good primer for a good finish at the Daytona race, but not so lucky. He finished 22nd. Not good. But that's the way it goes, I guess. I was a little disappointed, and again, a Daytona win eludes Stewart. So now back to the race. You've probably already read the news and watched news reports or read them online or something about how crappy the track was, like an hour, 2 hour delay twice for a track malfunction. I mean, come on, this is Daytona. Wrecks aside, it didn't really look that serious, and I'm not sure why it takes an hour to fix that problem, but it did. What do you do? Drivers cool down, cars cool down, they lose their focus, lose their momentum. With a race like Daytona, things have got to be moving at such a big track, and things are so spread out that when there's big delays, people lose interest. I'm sure the fans were going crazy there. I would hate to be stuck at that place for hours without really understanding why and what's going on. And you want to finish watching the race. There was only like 70 laps left when the first red flag came out, and then something like 30 or 40 laps when the second one came out. It was crazy. So congrats to McMurray for a win. It's good for him. I'm sure. I mean, that's the race of a lifetime, the win of a lifetime. Very few people win once, let alone win more than once. And so, good for McMurray. So next week is the Auto Club 500 in Fontana, California. I love Fontana. I love the road racing style. And look out for Stewart. He's a great. Great, he has a great, always has a great showing there. Gordon has a great showing there. Johnson, who I'm not exactly sure, he sort of fell apart at Daytona. He should have a good race there, and love to see Juan Pablo Montoya. He's always aggressive at a track like that because he thinks he has to be, has to drive differently because that was sort of where he came from. So, anyways, that's my NASCAR Daytona 500 2010 wrap up.